Back here in the islands, changes to short-term rentals could happen soon with summer just around the corner.
Dallas Ontiveros joins us live from Honolulu Hale with more details. Morning, Dallas.
Good morning, Christine Ross. Yes, we're talking about Bill 41 this morning, and here rejoining us on Wake Up Today, we have Joe Kent, who's the Executive Vice President of the Grassroot Institute of Hawaii. Good morning, Joe. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Thank you.
So we're continuing our conversation here about Bill 41, the future of short-term rentals. You know, if this bill just does get signed by Mayor Rick Blangiardi, what's going to happen to the places that have been grandfathered in and who are operating differently right now?
Well, there's about 800 lucky ducks from the 1980s who got a non-conforming use certificate that can still do short-term rentals. But if you're not one of those 800 people, you basically can't do it across Oahu. Now, unless you live in the resort districts, in which case you could do it for 90 days, but you still have to get registered. So this is a whole bunch of red tape that is covering Oahu. It's a blanket ban on short-term rentals.
But in a way, doesn't Bill 41 somewhat help the hotel industry because there's this big shift with short-term rentals?
That's right. So if people can't stay in short-term rentals, they'll stay in a hotel. And now, you know, there's only so much hotel space, and now we're going to use that even more. So this is going to jack up prices in hotels, who already have risen their prices because of our increased taxes on hotels.
And we all know international travel hasn't fully reopened either, so that's going to be another factor too.
That's true. And locals also pay for these high prices when they visit Tutu on Thanksgiving. They're all going to be competing for space in Waikiki.
So, in your own words, why do you think Bill 41 was passed with a 7-to-1 vote?
It was passed to ease the housing situation, but vacation rentals are not really the problem with the housing situation. The problem is we live in a state that has the most burdensome housing regulations in the nation. If lawmakers focused on that, they could do a lot to ease the housing situation, but this is more of a scapegoat.
And I know in the last half hour you mentioned in this Bill 41, in your own words, vacation cops would be included, which means that 7 people would go through these popular websites looking for those who are operating differently, who are not following the rules. But how are they going to really regulate this? Are they going to be showing up at your house, or how do you even prove that you are following the rules?
So there are going to be 7 full-time vacation cops who will send out notices and requests to inspect your home and see if you really are doing a short-term vacation rental, or if it's really a long-term rental, and they'll ask you all kinds of questions. So this is a violation on privacy and property rights, and it's a huge enforcement division that is going to be funded.
Joe Kent, thank you so much for joining us here on Wake Up Today, and we look forward to the future for more updates on this issue.
Thanks so much.
And again, Mayor Rick Blangiardi has not signed Bill 41 yet, so if there are any more developments, we will keep you posted first, whether it's through our KH12 mobile app, where you can receive breaking alerts, free to download, and also on our website at KH12.com. Reporting here from the Honolulu Hale, Dallas Ontiveros, KH12 News, working for Hawaii.
Thanks for the live update, Dallas.